Okay, so this hand's reasonable. We have turn one Chalice, and then a turn two Pyromancy, and then any other mana source turns the Pyromancy on, so we can start winning the game. Note that we also dump our hand in order to get the Pyromancy into play on turn two, so turn one Chalice, turn two Pyromancy, and the only cards left are Pyromancy, Blightsteel Colossus, and then whatever we've drawn for the turn. So Pyromancy actually kills much quicker than it appears. We also have two threats, so if he counters the first Pyromancy, we have a second one. And we don't actually know what our opponent is doing. I have the hunch that he's on miracles, like those there. That's the common miracles opening, but he could very well be playing like a blue-white Stoneblade deck too. Supreme Verdict. Interesting that that's still in his deck. Okay, he is on Miracles. Maybe he shouldn't have played the City of Traitors there. He reveals a land. Seething Song is resolving. And yeah, I'm just gonna go for the win. We know this counter's balance isn't hitting it. He needs to have a force of will, a second force of will in hand, which he does. Pitching Brainstorm. So this is awkward. Maybe I should have led off with Pyromancy. This Pyromancy takes double red and sneak attack we could have played with a top decked mountain. On the other hand, our opponent has a counterbalance in play and no cards in hand, so we have time. And yeah, we shouldn't have even played the City of Traitors. We're probably just going to lose it here soon. Okay, another sneak attack. The nice thing is if our opponent plays a Jace, if he's drawn and he uses it to draw towards hard counters, it's gonna take him a bit because he already burned two Force of Wills, so he's not necessarily gonna hit hard counter magic very quickly. And if he Fate Seals, like he doesn't know to bottom all of our red sources, which is what we need to win the game. He also just lost connection to the game, so if he comes back soon. Alright, he hit his fourth mana, no Jace. That's a good sign. Sandstone Needle, that's awesome. Because not only will it cast Sneak Attack, it'll also cast this Pyromancy. I think I'll just lead out with Sneak Attack here. Ancient Tomb to pay for a Spell Pierce. Reveal Senzai's Divining Top. So he's probably shuffling before he brainstorms here to try and find a counter. No, he has a Venser. That's obnoxious. Okay. Moat. He probably should have attacked with that Venser first. Like I have double Ancient Tomb and stuff. Yeah, Moat doesn't actually do anything. I could even play Pyromancy just to be super ridiculous. But I think Grizzlebrand's better. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Grizzlebrand's still better. And try and hit. Well, not only is it gonna not only will the Grizzlebrand draw me natural mana sources to play this Pyromancy, which is super good, but it'll also possibly just draw me an Emrakul for the win. So, I'll just do that. Hope he doesn't have a Spell Pierce or have his Counterbalance Blind Flip. Reveals a land. Okay, and there's Emrakul. Yay. So Moat, not the best against this deck. Shuts off Blightsteel Colossus, and that's about it. Alright. I don't think that matters. And he was pretty dead before, but he's still pretty dead. I'm gonna discard this Ancient Tomb, and probably want to keep this Sandstone Needle through the Breach. I don't really need. And he has no cards in hand, so I'm going to Blightsteel him. Because that's way more fun than Emrakul. Whee! Alright. Time for the next round.